Insperity presents the Small Business Advocate Show with Jim Blasingame, brought to you by FedEx, CareerBuilder.com, and Palo Alto Software. This is a copyrighted production of Small Business Network, Inc., all rights reserved.
Back 17 till. I'm Jim Blasingame. Thanks for hanging out with me. My website is smallbusinessadvocate.com. I hope you check it out when you get a chance. This month, is the 14th anniversary of the founding of that website, and we're very proud of it. We update it every day for you, and a lot of stuff there that will help you with your small business. Don't forget to subscribe to my free newsletter while you're there. Don't forget to take the poll question. Every week we ask a different question right there on the homepage. We want to know what you think, and when you click your answer, you'll be able to see how the poll is going so far. I'm broadcasting live from Woodlands, Texas, which is north of Houston at the Insperity Championship. This is my eighth consecutive year to broadcast from here. It's golf and small business, Paul. Paul Sarvati is with us, folks. He's the chairman, CEO, and co-founder of Insperity, the host and sponsor of this tournament. It's the Champions Tournament. And, Paul, congratulations on what a great success, 8 years.
Yeah, it's been great, and we're looking forward to another exciting week.
Yeah. Paul, this year, your company has gone through a lot of changes, and I've watched it, and you've allowed me to be part of some of it. Thank you for allowing us to hang out with you during some of these times. But I mean, you've gone through a brand change, right? A 25-year name became a new name. You've got some new direction with your company, some additional things that you're working on. You've expanded your product list. I mean, there's a lot of new things going on. Talk to us about that process. What did you learn? What have you learned from thinking about doing it to doing it and now executing on what you did?
Certainly. We've gone through a comprehensive business transformation over the last 2 years or so would be the implementation period, but there was a 2-year preparation period before mm-hmm. that. So, you know, we have, after 25 years of a tremendous legacy of success where we developed the most comprehensive business performance solution in the marketplace, which is our workforce optimization solution that mm-hmm. thousands of small and mid-sized businesses are outsourcing the HR function. And, you know, we provide administrative relief, better benefits, reduced liability, a technology platform, and a customized service plan that helps these businesses link their HR plan with their business strategy. And it's a tremendous service. We've had tremendous success. But I always felt like we could grow faster. We could do more. We could help more small businesses, especially if we could help those that weren't quite ready for the full comprehensive mm-hmm. solution. And so for 25 years, we found those customers that fit and served them extremely well and helped their businesses succeed. But we felt like there were many companies that we could have helped in some way.
Even though you knew that that was going to take you out of your comfort zone, you were going to have to stretch, you were going to have to do some things that would be a little bit challenging and maybe even have some potential for failure. You had to take some chances.
Well, no question.
Even though
it.
You were successful and comfortable, this is what a lot of small business owners are dealing with right now.
Yeah, we did not have to make this change. We've had a very successful company. We have an unlimited opportunity where we could continue to do the same thing and grow at a decent rate. Since we went public in 1997, our revenue growth is in the 22% range. Mm-hmm. That's not bad.
That's pretty darn good.
So we're doing fine. But we felt like we could do a lot more. And over the past several years, we used a build, buy, and partner strategy. We bought some companies. We extended some of our core services out on a standalone basis, and we partnered with some of our closest business partners, to offer some additional services to our customers. And then we had to go through the major transformation that to lead our 2,000 corporate employees from where we were to where we want to go. And that we've done in phases. We're in the third phase of this transformation.
And you could never minimize the challenge that can be, because people like what they've been doing. They like how things are. They get comfortable with it. It's their paradigm, right? And when you change that, that's one at a time, right? I mean, you have to bring everybody along
Absolutely.
One at a time, don't you?
The reality of shifting a paradigm is that's a significant obstacle, mm-hmm. and it has to be carefully and persistently orchestrated and executed.
Because if you got employees who have helped you get to where you are, and you have those, you can't take their feelings for granted, can you?
Absolutely not. What they're feeling is very real, and it affects how they behave.
Well, you've instilled that pride in them for what you had. Now you're asking them to buy into something different, and this is something that I think holds back a lot of small business owners. They get resistance from the employees when they talk about changes, because as you know, having been a small company once upon a time,
absolutely,
you know what it's like when you say, "Hey, what if we do this?" and people push back on you.
Sure, you know, I started the company with one partner in 1986. So
two desks and one phone, huh?
Exactly. And I've been through every stage that small and mid-sized businesses go through, and been blessed enough to get to where I now experience what some larger companies mm-hmm. go through as well. But it's interesting to me because there's a dynamic that says figure out what to do well and keep doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Be persistent, be not weary
stick
and
to
well
your knitting.
Doing, stick
mm-hmm.
to your knitting,
mm-hmm.
all that. And that's very true. But there's also are times when, whether it's driven by external pressures,
right.
market changes, things that are going on where you know in your gut
mm-hmm.
either what you're doing doesn't feel right anymore, doesn't feel like you can accomplish what you want to continue in
right.
that, or you see some new opportunities out
right.
there that maybe have been presented now because of the changes in
and
the marketplace.
And that's what the leaders have – that's their job. That's what the CEOs have to do, isn't it? See that to be able to take that, put that vision into focus.
Absolutely. You have to be able to work on your business, not just in your business.
Well said. We'll take a quick break first. We're going to talk some more with Paul Sarvati right after these messages. He's the CEO, co-founder, and chairman of Insperity. Stay with us.
Insperity presents the Small Business Advocate Show with Jim Blasingame, brought to you by FedEx, CareerBuilder.com, and Palo Alto Software. This is a copyrighted production of Small Business Network, Inc., intended for the private use of our audience. Except as otherwise provided by copyright law, all other copying, redistribution, or publication without prior written consent is prohibited. All rights reserved. Prohibited. All rights reserved. Prohibited.